I want to be a stooge.
Well, you can be like those three if you don't use common sense.
Yes, indeed.
All you need is a high intelligence.
Yes, sirree, they're the three musketeers of comedy. They have fun, we have fun.
I want to be a stooge.
Yeah! Hollywood, California, glamour capital of the world, where movie history was first written by such greats as Valentino, Fairbanks, Bickford. Today, a new chapter, television, and carrying on in the tradition of the immortals, we find...
Home cooking, snack you like home cooking, ha-da, delicious rolls, delicious rolls.
Hey, Caruso, you want the manager should hear you?
If she finds out we're cooking in the room, we're goners. You know the trouble we had finding this place.
You better start cooking for the TV show for tomorrow, or you'll answer to me. Now, sound off.
Okay, Chief. Hello, everybody. It gives me great pleasure on this monotonous occasion.
Hey. It's momentous. Momentous.
Now, what are you giving me two words for when I'm having so much trouble with one?
I smell cooking in there.
Battle stations.
Now, open the door.
Looking the same as ever.
Thank you. Now, I know I detect the odor of cooking in this room, which this hotel will not tolerate.
Cooking? What a lively imagination.
I dare say it's the aroma from the beanery across the street. It floats in here all day long.
Well, you know the rules. And as a manager here, I... Do you have to play that so loud?
It means goodbye. You and your home cooking. This is the 10th place we've tried, and they better let us in.
Hey, this place is too noisy.
What?
I say there's too much noise. I won't be able to concentrate. Only got one day to learn my line.
The line ain't so tough. Momentous occasion. Say it.
Mononymous occasion. Mononymous occasion.
Hey, fellas, get a load of this.
What?
Yeah. Lonely retired gentleman desires rumors. Home cooking. First month free.
First month free?
Yes.
And home cooking. Hey, where is this idyllic habitation?
Oh, those words you can say.
Yeah. Wait a minute. It's a place called Creepy Manor. It's in Lompoc.
Oh, Lompoc.
Yeah.
That's 100 miles away. Come on. Wait, wait.
Ow!
Which one of you guys does the cooking?
I do.
Now we're commuting to Creepy Manor.
In Lompoc.
Oh, man.
Answer the door, Nick.
Looks like a country club for zombies.
Then you ought to feel right at home.
We came in answer to the ad.
Huh? Say, did you ever make it to Disneyland?
Welcome to Creepy Manor, gentlemen. I'm Professor Dulato. Won't you come in?
Here.
Believe it or not, you're just in time to see the final sketch of my all-purpose missile carrier. Huh, I'll show you. It's all mine.
Here are the plans. Now, this button operates it underwater. This one sends it underground. This one propels it in the air. And this one puts it in orbit. The motto.
This guy's in orbit himself.
Well, it was nice meeting you, Professor.
Yeah, we gotta be on our way.
Oh, no, gentlemen, wait. My days are so lonely and monotonous.
That's momentous.
I get it!
It'd be so nice to have earthlings around the house.
Did you say earthlings?
That's right. You see, I'm often bothered by a spy from outer space who wants to steal my plans. He's a weird-looking character with deep-set eyes, a green face, and protruding teeth. And instead of hands, he has claws.
Like a little monster type.
Oh, of course. We'll stay.
Good, good. Nick will show you to your tomb. I mean, room. Good.
Mo? About that professor.
Don't pay any attention to what the old guy said about the spy from outer space. He's been bending over those diagrams too long.
Well, just the same, I'm taking no chances.
Where did you get that?
Off the wall.
Chicken. If anything happens, I'll be across the hall. Now get some shut-eye. We gotta be in shape for our show tomorrow. Good night.
Good night. On this monanimous occasion... That's not right. Moninimous occasion. Motinimous.
Dream about it. Turn out the lights. I'm bushed.
Yelling about?
They're here.
They're here? Who's here?
From outer space.
You're off your rocker.
No, listen to me, Mom. I'm telling you the truth.
Oh, Mabel. You're here at last. You swept me off my feet. I'm being carried away. I'm safe. Safe in your arms, darling. Safe.
I tell you, the spaceman, I saw him. A guy could get murdered.
It'll be you if you don't let me get some sleep.
Mo, please. Come on. I'll show you what happened. Come on. Right in here. I know what happened right over here. I'll show you. Right there. The call came through there. It looked just like a can opener. then it pulled the chain like that, and then it went back in the wall, and this covered the hole.
Hole? The hole is in your head. Why can't you be like Larry, sleeping like a baby? Move over, Larry, and let Joe in. Move over, I said. Now, any more trouble out of you, and I'll give you something to yap about. Go on.
A tourist from Mars.
Yeah, sure, with a card from the Diners Club.
Hey, lift him up. I'll look for a rope. Hey, Mo! Mo! It's the butler!
It's always the butler. Hey, here comes another one. You're all right. It was only a blow on the head.
Gentlemen, what's going on up here?
Huh? That's him. That's the fellow that tried to steal my plane.
No, he's innocent. It was your butler.
No.
Yeah.
Ah, then you shall be the one to take my space carrier into orbit.
Oh, huh? No.
Yes.
Oh, no.
What?
Get out of here.
We got a long way to run, fellas.
Hey, what are we running for? We got a car.
We had a car. I left the keys upstairs in the pants.
Larry, Moe, Curly Joe, they're the funniest guys I know. Golly gee, that's for me. I wanna be a stooge. Larry clowns, Moe he frowns. Joe makes all of those crazy sounds. What a scream, what a scheme. I wanna be a stooge. You can be like those three if you don't use common sense.
Yes, indeed. All you need is a stooge.